Hello, happy new week, and the storm that we've all survived didn't kill us all, which is great news for the climate emergency is holding off for the time being. Seems to me interesting that the political world is all about acceptance. So it's about an established political model whereby people are meant to disagree with each other and there's tension and then they have an argument and the best argument wins. But it's now seemed to turn into something else, which is like an established establishment. Well, maybe it's always been that way. A sort of view that only certain views are acceptable and only the holders of certain views are acceptable and allowed in the public sphere. So what you end up with is a country like the UK today where Port Talbot is going to lose 3,000 jobs, the steelworks in Port Talbot, to try and keep up with net zero targets. But the people who own Tata Steel is Indian, isn't it? And then the other big steel manufacturer is Chinese, and they're just making steel till the cows come home, whilst we have to go poor and immiserate ourselves for the sake of net zero climate scam communism, which is of no fun to anybody. So what we've got is thousands of jobs being lost in Port Talbot in Wales in the steel industry to satisfy the net zero maniacs. And net zero is just another way of controlling people, and controlling people and making them live to your own standards and ideals isn't civilization, it's communism. So Tata Steel in India and China and their economies are doing really well, where our economy is being destroyed by this ridiculous idea of net zero. Then you go to the National Health Service, which is another socialist institution, where you can't get a doctor's appointment or an operation appointment. So you're sat at home in this dreadful storm with your rheumatoid arthritis and other aches and pains and hip replacements and various things needed, and you can't get it dealt with because the National Health Service shut itself down for 2 years to deal with a cold, and now it cannot recover. And from what I hear from many, many people, cancer services on the National Health Service are pretty much non-existent at this juncture in time. So you would have thought with these sort of fundamental problems that we got in the United Kingdom, that's putting aside the fact that people are marching around the capital city of our country calling for murder, and Jewish people are frightened to leave their houses. So we've got international conflicts playing on our stage, on the public stage. You've got members of parliament who were selected for reasons only of their gender and their ethnicity sitting there representing constituents of places that are thousands of miles away from us. I mean, I don't know if you've watched any Labour MPs talking in the last few months, but you would be very hard pushed to work out that they were an MP for Coventry, for example. You'd think more the MP for Gaza North. So with the problems that you have with our own political climate in this country, with the cost of lockdown crisis, the free speech crisis, which continues unabashed, and unless it's the right sort of free speech, like killing Jews, that's acceptable free speech. You would have thought that the insurgent political party that wishes to get out there and really get Britain moving again and make Britain great again, or take back Britain, or whatever its slogan is, would be focused on Britain. But no, the leader of said political party, a certain Sir Richard of the Tice, is in Ukraine delivering medical supplies. Why is that annoying? It's really annoying because all of the reasons I discussed earlier, that we've got problems in our own country. And secondly, what is the stated military objective in Ukraine? Can someone tell me what it is? Because I'd love to know before another generation of Ukrainian men are massacred at the altar of doing the right thing in this sort of fake Churchillian way of trying to lead the country into something more popular. So, you know, I don't have any respect. If you're an insurgent political party, you need to be fighting for your own people. You need to be cleaning up your own backyard before you start going and virtue signaling the old blue and the yellow. So poor move, sorry, Richard, but in the spirit of good heartedness, I really believe and want insurgent parties to do well in this country, and Reform is one of them, and I hope they do really well. And I think Ben Habib is an amazingly passionate person, and he's not frightened of talking about the culture, which means his tenure at Reform won't be long. I guarantee you that. The establishment don't like it when you talk about things like the culture wars. We saw what Keir Starmer said about the culture wars yesterday. The people that invented cancel culture gaslight you for pointing out that you don't like cancel culture. Anyway, I've made this suggestion a million times before. We should all work together. It's the only way we can do it, and we should actually be using our energy to try and make the Conservatives Conservatives, and actually, almost more importantly, Labour, Labour. I mean, they were, after all, invented to look after the well-being of the working man, not trying to chop boys' dicks off and turn them into girls. So we have a political crisis in the country, and the leader of the insurgent party has decided to go to Ukraine so he can take a picture of himself next to Mr. Zelensky, if he can get a meeting, and the Ukrainian flag to say, I've done the good bit by Ukraine. All the while, the people of Wellingborough are probably trying to work out what Reform UK is going to do for them, not the people of the Donbass. Cheerio.